If someone came up to you and I and asked, hey, what is the benefit of software-defined networking, SDN, or software-defined wide area networking, SD-WAN, one of the benefits would be once it's in place, well, we can also roll out devices much easier. And also once it's in place, it's easier to manage. It takes less manpower to, or woman power or person power to manage those networks. And now a big reason for that is because with software-defined networking, we're doing some separation. Whack, whack. We're separating two planes, and I'm not talking like a 737 and a Cessna. I'm talking about separating the control plane from the data plane. So I'd like to take a look at a topology with you, explain what that means, and then also why it's important and give you an example of how it's done in SD-WAN. What exactly is the control plane? The control plane is about the how, like how to do something. Like, what does a router need to know? Well, a router, if it gets a packet that comes in here, it needs to know, how do I forward it? Do I forward it out A, or do I forward it out B, or do I drop it? So the control plane is teaching the devices how to do something. And in most cases, in a company, we're going to use something like a dynamic routing protocol that dynamically allows these routers to work with each other, like OSPF, to learn how to forward traffic. So in this small network with six routers, if they're all running OSPF, they're generating messages which are propagated across the whole network. And eventually, R1, actually, shouldn't say eventually, it won't take very long. R1's going to know about all the details about R2, R6, R4, and R3. And it can build from its perspective with all that information, it can figure out, okay, based on packets coming in, I know how to route now because I learned all that information. I did my calculations. That's all about the control plane. So the control plane is a lot like going to meetings at work. If we have going to a meeting and there's like eight or nine people there and they're all giving us their information, like here's the procedure for this or here's how to do that. Great, we're learning how to do something. Now later, after the meeting, if it comes down to doing something, then we'd have to actually go to work and actually start working or do the work. And in a data network, that do the work process is referred to as the data plane. In the concept of a router, it would be actually routing or forwarding the packet. So I'll use blue for that. I'll call this the data plane. So Bob's packet comes in, the router looks at its routing table and says, oh yeah, I've already figured out my routing table. I already know what to do. Now I'm going to go ahead and start forwarding Bob's packet, and I'll forward out this way and down to R3, and R3 makes a forwarding decision, and R4 makes a forwarding decision, and then it goes out. And along the way, we could have NAT and other things that are done to that traffic. So traditionally, a single device like router 1 would be in charge of the control plane with its routing protocol and the data plane. Now, unfortunately, if the control plane is on each and every router, if we wanted to make drastic changes across the whole network, we've got to touch R1 and R2 and R6 and R4 and R3 and modify their behavior so they behave as we want them to. And that's because the control plane and the data plane are both right here. But what if we somehow took the control plane and instead of putting every router in charge of that, we moved that responsibility, the education and the brains of the operation, we moved that to an external device, not the routers themselves, but something else. So let's take a look at what that would look like. So we have the control plane function, which is again, the how to do something. And if we move that to a separate device, and that could be a device that's on-prem or in the cloud, and it would be referred to as a controller. So what we would do is say, hey, Mr. R1, instead of taking all your information from all the other routers in your group, just go ahead and chat with the controller, and the controller will tell you what to do regarding routes and how to reach the next hops and all those things. The controller can figure it out. So we have R1 and R2 and R6 and R4 and R3 all communicate with this controller, and the controller, using a routing protocol between itself and the device that it's providing information to, can still educate these routers on how to forward, except now because we're doing it at the controller, we can set up policies and we can implement changes very, very easily by manipulating the controller. And in an SD-WAN environment, that controller has a very specific name and it is called vSmart. And with all of our routers talking to vSmart instead of peering with each other and figuring out the control plane based on their direct communications, vSmart can rain down that information and then these routers can focus on the data plane, which is actually forwarding the packets. So Bob's packet comes in and R1 forwards it and this guy forwards it. So the routers are still primarily responsible for the data plane, but it's the controller and vSmart specifically that's gathering and propagating routing information, next hop information, all those details down to all the devices in our network so they can make their forwarding decisions on the data plane. If we go back to our meeting example, this would be like instead of meeting with eight or nine other people at our company and talking to them all every 10 minutes, it'd be like talking to a supervisor or a manager just occasionally, and that manager or supervisor would say, you know what, I got your back. Just do what I tell you. You don't need to listen to everybody else, and you'll be absolutely fine. Also, I will give you the information, says the controller or the supervisor. I'll tell you about the IP addresses, the next hops for the routes and the prefixes I give you. I will tell you about the encryption keys that you need and the ports involved. I'll give you everything you need. Trust me. I'll tell you how to make those forwarding decisions. And then your job, Mr. Router, says vSmart, is just to forward those packets when they come in and be happy about it. And the router says, gotcha. Centralized control plane separated from the router. And then the router is primarily responsible for the data plane. So in an SD-WAN environment, it would look something like this. We'd have vSmart, which again could be up in the cloud or it could be on-prem as a virtual machine, either way. And our edge devices, that Site 10, Site 20, Site 30, and Site 40, they all build a control connection to vSmart, and then vSmart tells them what to do. So the routers, these edge devices in our SD-WAN environment, primarily regarding routing, they can do OSPF and other routing protocols locally and have other services, but for the major routing across the SD-WAN, that information is being propagated to each of them by the controller in the cloud, and that is vSmart. And if we look at one of these edge devices, this is Site 20 to a show IP route. Right here, it's going to show us a whole bunch of routes. On the far left, it's showing the VPN number, which is just a fancy way for saying the group of routes. So for VPN 10, we have all these routes. Here's an example of one of them. This is pointing to the 10.0.10 network. It was learned via OMP, and OMP is the language of love or the routing protocol used between an edge device in SD-WAN and vSmart. And if we want to take a closer look at that, we could use the command show control connections, and it will show us that we have some connections up to vSmart right here. So it's vSmart in the cloud. That's the controller that's advertising information, including prefixes and the next hop information, also crypto keys and some other details down to our edge devices. So what are the major benefits of separating the control plane, the education of routing information and so forth, separating that control plane from the data plane is that by moving the control plane to vSmart with SD-WAN, we can then manipulate policy centrally and just have that information rain down. And then the routers, still focused on the data plane, can do their primary job. And they're going to have less overhead because they only have to peer with a vSmart or two, and they don't have to peer with all the other routers regarding the control plane and learning all the details. Another great question that comes up is, how did this edge device, in our case it was VEdge 20, how did it know to talk to vSmart? And why was vSmart willing to talk to it? How did we coordinate all those communications? Well, that's the role of another device in our three musketeers of management in SD-WAN. And that device is called vBond, V-B-O-N-D. And we'll have a separate video just on that. So thanks for joining me, and I'll see you in the next video.